Hello, my beautiful Pisces. Welcome to my channel. This is your favorite fortune teller, Divine Light. And today I'm going to do a coffee cup reading for this upcoming lunar and solar eclipse. We're going to check to see how the energies are affecting you. Also, I'm going to put a link up here in the description box below. If you would like a private reading from me, you can just go ahead and book your reading from there. And also, don't forget to hit subscribe and give this one a thumbs up if you're enjoying this. Subscription is free. You can unsubscribe anytime you want. But it helps the channel a lot and also helps this message get to the ones who really need to hear it as well. Okay, let's jump into your reading and let's see what is coming your way. Okay, I see here there's a desire, there's a wish you have, and there's a chunk of money. Well, yep, it's falling. But it seems like it is going to be after the solar eclipse, okay? Solar eclipse is going to be probably at April 8th. That's like, I'm going to put it in the title as well. And there's a tear of joy coming initially during the lunar time. This seems like a little dark tear, but it feels like there's going to be a healing. We're going to interpret this part as the solar, this part as the lunar eclipse. There's going to be a healing coming forward for you, okay? Maybe if you're in a situation that you are actually going through it and you're trying to find a solution to it, but the solution is not coming up, the people not showing up, it seems like here you're going to be actually finding the solution. That's why you're going to initially have a little aggressive tear, and then it's going to turn into a solution for you right there. Okay, I see there's beautiful. Everything seems beautiful. First of all, initially I saw a dragon here, and then I saw a goat up here, and then there's a male figure behind the goat. Masculine energy is all about taking action. This can be your energy. It doesn't have to be a male coming forward. I see a letter E here. It can be in the first name or the last name of this person, or maybe in your last name or the first name. Another thing with the dragon is it's coming during the solar eclipse, and it seems like it is going to be moving things, start to move things in your life massively, because lunar eclipse is all about like emotions, finding out whatever is hurting you. This can be a person right here, kind of has like a little tail here. Maybe you're dealing with a negative energy. And number 9 is actually right on his cloak where his like a tail is. Number 9, like this is what I see: the mouth, the eye, the flat hair, there's a leg right there, the tail here. So number 9 indicates enlightenment, understanding, having patience and self-awareness. Also having self-compassion and completing a cycle. And this person is actually, I see a little dog here, kind of like a loyalty. They have a certain loyalty to you, but this loyalty doesn't mean that they have like a loyalty on the level that we're understanding. This person is here for you to have an enlightenment and understanding about situations, maybe relationships, or maybe this can be a competitor at work, or someone that you're working with doesn't respect your boundaries, and it's time for you to actually show, like it is time. They're here to show you or teach you how to say no, or maybe how to say yes, or how to claim what's yours. There's an enlightenment happening with this person, and this can be like a soul contract. And even if you don't believe in that, it's basically about learning a lesson here. Whatever it is that you're completing, that. That's why we had maybe like initially a stressful tear, and then afterwards it's going to turn into something massive, bright environment. I even see here like a protection bubble surrounding you. So whatever that you're going through with this person, this situation, it is actually under the protection of your angels. Okay, you are actually being protected here, even if the things doesn't seem like it is going for the worst. You're completing a life lesson here, and even see here that you're wearing a crown on top of your head. So completing a cycle. I see there's a candle here burning, like a little tea light candle. Candles usually indicates a wish, a desire coming your way. So if you have like a specific desire, a wish in your mind, it is good to just put it on the paper, just keep it in front of you all the time as it is completed. You already accomplished it, because the spirit, the universe is listening, basically, whatever is coming out of your mouth, and it's ready to deliver, because it is looking very bright here. None of the other signs had this much of like brightness and the wish fulfillment coming forward. And when it comes to solar time, though, we have, there's going to be movement coming forward. I see someone here leaning over you who's wearing a hat. You can see, and you're right here, you're having a conversation with this person, and leaning towards each other here. This person might have like letter L as in Larry in their first name or the last name, and Elmer maybe. and you have like a bag under your arm here. That can be just reminded me of Four of Pentacles energy, which is actually being careful about being frugal about your finances and your emotions, your thoughts, and whatever it is that you're sharing with others. Do not share it, overshare it, do not give it freely. But maybe if you have like a great idea without seeing the security of that this person is going to be helping you, do not share it freely, all the details of your bright ideas that is coming to you, because that is meant for you. Okay, but you are actually sharing, hiding the thoughts, but you're sharing the idea probably in a very summary scale here with them, and they might actually open little short paths for you so you can travel. I see there is another person here. This can be your energy as well. You're hugging up a cat here and a dragon is next to you. This can be eventually whatever it is that you're having, it's starting. We have a little duck here, which kind of indicates, I have this tarot deck called Wild Unknown Tarot. You can unknown tarot. Sometimes I speak so fast. In that, the full card is actually a baby duck, okay? So this can, baby chicken, actually. This kind of looks like that one. So this is the new beginning, the full energy, the Libra energy. You're stepping into something that is actually unknown to you, taking a leap of faith. And you can see how bright it is turning out for you. And we have the dragon wrapping around this thing, kind of shapes like you. So this is going to be your probably path to wealth and creating wealth in your life. Okay, let's get into your plate now. If you have a question, a desire, an intention, there are two chunks of money showing here during the solar eclipse. Hold it in your mind. Let's see what the answer is going to be for that. I saw a person initially standing here. Number three is forming. This is about your creative power. There is a protective bubble surrounding you, and I feel like somebody's actually, there's a pregnant woman also showing up here. That kind of indicates that you are actually creating something. And this might initially cause you discomfort, because like marriage is and this uncomfortable experience towards the end. So towards the end of like bringing this thing to life, you might have some discomfort. And it might also take a while, but there is a second desire coming forward unexpectedly. I feel like that is actually going to keep your spirits up, so you're not going to be stuck with this thing moving slow, okay? I see there are people behind you helping you out, and there's a person standing by the edge, by the fence. They're not stepping forward. Okay, your desire like coming forward, but it has some time, whatever it is that you're building here. They want to come forward. But they want to come help you, maybe communicate to you. There's somebody waiting outside, lunar eclipse time. Maybe this is someone that you are actually forgiving, letting go. Maybe you haven't been talking for a while. And they want to come forward. They want to talk to you, but they are waiting for your permission to allow them. This can be because the lunar eclipse is all about forgiveness, letting go what doesn't serve you. And this is a person that actually done you wrong and still maybe trying to contact you. It's good to, resolve the situation rather than keeping them hanging on to, the past and keeping them something from the past, okay? Maybe when you actually talk to them, they'll probably let you go as well. We had the Ace of Wands here, a new adventure, a new endeavor, a job, maybe a business forward, coming forward here, a new travel opportunity and moving, relocation. We have the Magician here. Magician has all the tools in front of him. So this indicates that whatever that you want to manifest, the tools will be given to you, okay? There can be a reference for getting into a school, maybe down payment for buying a house, can be like a rental apartment opportunity coming forward. And that might actually, okay, after you start doing the things, follow your heart and taking action, we have the Four of Cups come through. Four of Cups actually being bored in a situation. This kind of tells me, even though you have the opportunities, you might actually not be able to see them because you're going to be so indulged in, dive deep into maybe something past, something something that has a lot of space in your mind. In order to clear that, I see here Six of Pentacles comes through. Six of Pentacles here is actually all about giving and receiving. And we had Eight of Pentacles come through. Eight of Pentacles indicates learning as much as you can about a subject. When you do actually know more, that probably maybe there is this something that you want to accomplish and that maybe you don't know which path to go. That's why you're feeling a little bit like frustrated about it with the Four of Cups here. But Six of Pentacles, kind of like a simple explanation of giving comes back. Eight of Pentacles is actually increasing your knowledge about certain things. Okay, giving comes back can be material things, can also be the love, the appreciation. We have a calling here. Whatever is your calling, that's going to also come forward for you within this time period. And we have here the High Priestess energy. This is the Pisces energy. Okay, so your intuition is actually going to be guiding you regarding which way to go, so you can actually find these tools, manifest these tools, and create the world, the things that you want in your life. Okay, you're highly intuitive, you are the High Priestess, you're highly knowledgeable, and even though male and female doesn't matter, the Pisces has this inner knowing. Follow that inner knowing, because that will actually help you get to where you need to be. We have here Saturn, a life lesson is my knocking on my door. And I feel like this is with the Judgment card, actually something that you haven't let go you will be able to let it go during this lunar eclipse. Okay. All right, my beautifuls, that's all for today. Hope you enjoy your reading. If you do, don't forget to give this one a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of these, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. I wish you all a magical day. Bye.